Je t'adore, je Jay-Z. T'adore.
Course I love you. I love all y'all. For real.
I love girls, 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 girls. I do adore.
Yo, put your number on this paper, cause I would love to date ya. Holla at you when I come off tour. Yeah. I got the Spanish chica, she don't like me to roam. So she called me cabrón, plus mighty gone. So she likes to cook right, so she likes me home. I'm like, un momento, mommy, slow up your tempo. I got this black chick, she don't know how to act. Always.
Je t'adore, Jay-Z.
I love you. I love all you. For real.
I love girls, 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 girls. I do adore.
Yo, put your number on this paper, cause I would love to meet you. Holla at you when I come on top.
Ladies and gentlemen, how y'all doing? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? I had to play the girls, 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 girls. Ladies and gentlemen, it's going down. You at the Live, Love, Laugh show with your boy Tyrick Higgins. And man, oh man, we got a spicy one today. We got a spicy one today. If you're a Laker fan, if you're a diehard Laker fan, you don't want to hear about me talking about your king, it's time for you to leave, all right? It's time for you to go, because we about to get a little messy. Ladies and gentlemen, the king, King LeBron James, is not lifting the team up. He's not lifting the team up. Only thing he's doing is lifting himself up. Only thing he's doing is lifting himself. Ever since LeBron James put on a Lakers uniform, I felt nothing. I don't feel no magic. I don't feel no showtime. I feel nothing. Even with this little bubble championship he got, I still felt nothing. He brings nothing to LA. He doesn't bring no excitement to LA. Not the kind of excitement that Kobe brought. None of the showtime and excitement that Magic brought. He does not bring that excitement to LA. Well, for me, he doesn't. For me, he doesn't bring any, he doesn't touch my heart or my soul. Something about LeBron James. Does not say showtime. He don't bring no magic. There's no magic in LA with LeBron. Him, Anthony Davis, Russell Westbrook, they don't bring no magic to LA. LA looks disgusting. They've been disgusting since LeBron just got there. I'm sorry. I ain't saying he ain't a good player. I'm just saying he don't bring the magic, the showtime, to L.A. like Kobe and Magic did. The greats. The real greats. These are the real greats. I'm sorry. These are the real greats. These are my real, the ones I say are the real true GOATs. Yes, LeBron James is a great player. He is. I'm not saying he's not. I'm just saying there's something missing with LeBron that's just not GOATish. He don't have no GOAT-ish, no GOAT feel to it. It's just, I can't pinpoint what it is about LeBron James. It just don't give me the GOAT feel. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can feel GOAT, I get a GOAT feel out of Michael Jordan. I get a GOAT feel from Kobe Bryant. I get a GOAT feel from Larry Bird. But I don't get a GOAT feel from LeBron James. Yes, he's explosive. Yes, he's been playing his heart out. But something about his... I can't figure it out what it is about LeBron James that just don't feel goatish to me. It don't feel like a goat to me. The Lakers are 0-3. 0-3. You have two great players on your team, and you don't know how to make it work. Russell Westbrook has always been a triple-double machine. And he gets to L.A. with LeBron James and Anthony Davis, and he becomes a nothing machine. I wonder why. Maybe it's because LeBron James sucks the energy and the motivation out of you. Even Anthony Davis ain't really playing. He in and out. Russell Westbrook all the way, he's like done. Like, what happened? Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is not, he's not happy with about what's happening. He's not happy about what's about to happen. If LeBron James stays healthy this year, he's going to surpass him on the scoring leader on the scoring leaders list. If he stays healthy, he's going to pass Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the scoring list. What is that to be happy? He's not a Laker. LeBron is, he will never be a Laker. And I hope and I pray that before he's done playing, he goes back to Cleveland or somewhere else or back to Miami, whatever. But please don't end it here. Please don't. Because this is not for you. LA is not your, it's not. Realistically, you got here by accident. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about the GOAT, James. The GOAT. Y'all's GOAT. Not my GOAT. I don't feel nothing GOATish about LeBron James. He hasn't shown me no GOAT. He hasn't shown me nothing GOATish. All right? Nothing GOATish. He's just a good player, all right? He hasn't shown me nothing GOATish. There's rumors going on right now that LeBron James is out, cheating on Savannah. Savannah's his wife, for 9 years. Savannah James. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get into the story. That's what I like to do. I like to get into the stories because that's what I do. I get into the stories. I share the stories. Podcast reveals new details about how LeBron James allegedly cheats on his wife, Savannah. Let's get further into the story. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, if you have never seen his wife, that's him and his wife. There's LeBron. There's his wife, Savannah, right? All right. Now we got that out the way. Let's get into the story. On the court, LeBron James is a four-time NBA champion and undeniably one of the best at the game of basketball. Yes, he is. He definitely is. Off the court, James is touted as an amazing father of three and a devoted husband to his wife of 9 years, Savannah James. However, according to podcast host Sophia Franklin, the billion-dollar baller may not be as committed to his marriage as portrays. Rumors of infidelity surrounding the basketball star have circulated for years and are by no means new. So it isn't even new. However, they never materialize into anything factual or concrete. All right. In a recent episode of the Sophia with an F podcast, Franklin shared never-before-heard details about how James allegedly steps out on his high school sweetheart. It all started when a discussion about Maroon 5 lead singer Adam Levine and philandering took a sharp left and landed on the subject of LeBron and Leonardo DiCaprio. Wow. How did LeBron James end up... How do we get from Adam Levine, Leonardo DiCaprio to LeBron James? They don't even go together, but let's finish. Don't be dumb, Franklin says in regards to Levine. You are famous, Adam. You know how beep famous you are. You could be a little sly about it. Leonardo DiCaprio, I don't know for a fact. I've never been invited, but my friends have. He goes out and his bodyguards or whatever go up to the girls, ask if they want to go back to his house or wherever. They sign an NDA, a non-disclosure agreement. LeBron James saying, beep. Same thing with LeBron James? Let's get further. Realizing that she may have said a little too much, Franklin quickly caught herself. Should I be outing all these people? Please, feel free. Keep going. I want to know more about Adam Levine, Leonardo DiCaprio, and LeBron James, the game. It was then that someone off camera inquired about further details on LeBron James' moves. That's when Franklin decided to drop some more tea. Some more major tea. What did LeBron James do, they asked? LeBron James has various parties constantly with where NDAs, non-disclosure agreements, need to be signed and women are at. Franklin replied, you didn't know that? You didn't know LeBron's a cheetah? No, we did not know the king was a cheetah. We did not know. But cheating goes on definitely in LA and definitely with the Lakers. But let's finish the story, though. Let's finish the story. The viral clip posted on TikTok was captioned, if you're going to cheat, at least have respect and lower your beep voice, Adam, along with several hashtags, one of which including James's name. Reception to the clip, which has racked up over 1 million views on TikTok, was mixed. Some came after Franklin for her unsavory comments about the baller. She needs to leave LeBron's name out of this. At the end of the Lakers star route. You're not going to be slandering LeBron's name like this. I would not stand for it. Another edit. What? Can't even say nothing. One question why James' name came up in the first place. I would like to know how his name got mixed up in some white actors. Well, not white. Well, one's a white actor, one's a white, what is he, rock star, pop rock star? I don't know, Adam Levine, I don't know. I heard his name before. I knew it was one of them shows, whatever. Anyway, listen, how did LeBron James get into a conversation with two white guys? Anyway, man, but listen, let's get back to the story. So, how you go from talking about Adam Levine to spreading misinformation about LeBron James, they questioned. But not everyone was skeptical. Some viewers noted in the comments that Franklin's tea on James is well known. The LeBron information is very known in Cleveland, said a commentator. Said a commenter. From Cleveland, everybody knows about the king, LeBron James. Another echoed. Another wondered how these rumors will affect James' future. It ain't gonna affect his future at all. You know how many motherfuckers? Listen, all the greats cheated. All the greats. He's just another one. Hopefully his juice gets spilt and it's true. All right? How does it affect LeBron's legacy? User asked. Okay, so this one might actually affect LeBron's legacy. Another one determined. If James' legacy is on the line, his NBA season isn't helping. According to Total Pro Sports, the Lakers are having a rough time. I told you. Collapsing to 0-3 record after last week's loss to the Portland Trail Blazers. Though James played well in the game, managed to secure 31 points, 8 rebounds, 8 assists. Things still aren't looking good for the Lakers. They still ain't looking good for the Lakers. There's no showtime in LA. There's no showtime in LA. I love LA. I love it. I love LA. You can't love LA with LeBron in this motherfucker. LeBron and them, they are stinking the place up. You can't love LA. You can't. I don't love LA. I don't even want to watch them. Something about LeBron James and Lakers uniform just don't touch my heart, and it don't bring no magic. Don't put no showtime in LA. So what do you think? You think LeBron is having a little secret rendezvous, sexcapade parties, what are they called? Sex parties? You think he's having sex parties with other women? on the down low with teammates, and you know what I'm saying? If he is, he is. If he's having other relationships outside of his marriage, it happens all the time. Happens all the time in LA. You know what I'm saying? You know, Magic Johnson, one of the greats, one of the GOATs. In my opinion, Magic Johnson, one of the GOATs. He, you know, he had affairs on his wife, Cookie. You know, look, our boy, rest his soul, but Kobe Bryant, he was having affairs. Another one that's a GOAT. We ain't go outside the Lakers. There's so many greats, so many GOATs, you know, that could be in the GOATs, that could be called a GOAT, a great of all time. They had affairs. Even, like I said, even the one we all said a GOAT, Michael Jordan had tons of affairs too. MJ had affairs. So if LeBron James has an affair, he just has an affair. And, but either way, LeBron just don't feel goaty. He don't touch. He's just, something about LeBron just don't feel like a goat. It just don't. He never has. Maybe because he's never been stable. He's always jumping from team to 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 team. Maybe that's why he just don't. Can you keep still? Can you find one place? Can you just keep still? Larry Bird kept still. Magic Johnson kept still. Did I say Magic Johnson? Larry Bird, Magic Johnson. Even if, look, MJ went to the Wizards after he was pretty much done. But even MJ, he kept still. He kept still. But LeBron, you don't know how to keep still. You do too much moving for me. You try to find a happy place too many motherfucking times for me. And you will never, ever be a Laker in my eyes. I would say you was a Cavalier because that's where you started. I will say you was a Cavalier because that's where you started. I will not say you ain't no Miami Heat. No, you ain't no Laker. You are a Cavalier. You won a championship with the Cleveland Cavaliers. That's wonderful. You need to go back. When it's all done in LA, you need to take your GOATism back to Cleveland and end it there. Hopefully with your sons. Because that's what you're trying to do. You're trying to play until you're 50 years old. So your newer sons can play. But yeah, cheating is not new in LA. And he will never be a Laker. To me, he'll never be a Laker. Sorry, he will never be one. He'll be a great player, but never a GOAT. He just ain't did it for me yet. Maybe he'll do it before he die. Maybe he'll give me something before he go. Maybe I'm like, you know what? LeBron actually is got some GOAT in him. But I ain't feeling it. I'm not feeling the GOAT yet. I'm not feeling it. Maybe y'all feeling GOAT. Maybe y'all feeling like he a GOAT. But I don't feel like he a GOAT. Not yet. He's still playing pretty good. He's what, 38, 39? 38? Like I said, he's a great player. Maybe all his moves messed up the GOAT feel for me. I think that's what it was. I think all of his moving messed up that GOAT feel for me. I like to see stability. I like for you to have your feet grounded. I like to see you trying to build your team and you know, bring them up and make them better. That's what I like to see. I like to see that. I like that longevity, one team, one place. LeBron James could have stayed in Cleveland. Nobody was getting rid of LeBron. Nobody was getting rid of LeBron. Give me one minute. Turn this on real quick. Nobody was getting rid of LeBron. LeBron let his own self go. LeBron did this whole this old fake ass was it a damn some kind of conference and was on TV and all of Cleveland came in. He let Cleveland know that he was moving on to Miami. This shit was crazy. It was a circus. It was a circus. Nobody wanted LeBron to leave Cleveland. He didn't want to stay still. He wanted to chase rings with different damn teams. Bring the damn rings to Cleveland. So you got a ring in Cleveland, you got a ring in Miami, you got a ring in LA. What's next? Who's next? What's the next team? You gonna stay in LA? Please don't. Please don't stay in LA. Please, LeBron. Somebody have a connection with LeBron. Tell him I don't go somewhere else. Don't stay here. Matter of fact, fuck it. Team up with your boy Kevin Durant. Go to Brooklyn. Matter of fact, you know what? No. Do this better. This. Go to New York. Go to New York Knicks. Get him a championship. You want to be a GOAT? You want to be a GOAT? Go to the Knicks. Get the Knicks a ring. Then I might give you the GOAT. I might give it to you. Go to the Knicks. Get them a ring. Do that. Yes, go to the Knicks. I want to see the Knicks get a championship before I die. I want to see the New York Knicks get a championship ring before I die. Can you do that for me, LeBron? Bring the Knicks a ring, and I'll give you the GOAT. I'll call you the GOAT. Bring the Knicks a ring before I go, and before you retire, and we can go to that for you. I can go to that for you. I can call you the GOAT all day. But, hey, all the GOATs cheat. That's what we're talking about. We're talking about him cheating. It's even a possibility of Savannah cheating, too. Savannah's probably cheating too. You would think LeBron James home every fucking day, being a husband and being a damn daddy. You don't think Savannah get lonely at night? What's that song? If you think you're lonely now, woo. Wait until tonight. Yeah, that's that jam. Do you? If you think you're lonely, you think Savannah gonna sit at home by herself? In a big ass house with a bunch of fucking bratty ass kids all by herself, probably horny as a motherfucker. You think Savannah ain't getting no side niggling? You crazy. Y'all crazy. You think Savannah ain't jumping on balls? It's the NBA. They know their men. If you're married to a basketball player or football. In sports and entertainment, there's going to be a lot of cheating. A lot of home goes on. And it ain't just the entertainers. It's the spouses. They are getting an end. There's a lot of cheating, a lot of drugs, a lot of rock and roll, a lot of that. So I'm not surprised by the story if it's true or not. If LeBron James is hoeing, making women sign NDAs and all that, it's not a surprise. If you want to consider LeBron James the greatest of all time, then it fits. It fits. He likes side hoes. He likes women on the side. That's what goats do. It happens. It happens. Maybe once, maybe twice, maybe still doing it. I don't know, but I'm sure he's had some. If you think LeBron James didn't cheat, you stupid. If you think Savannah at home, keeping her legs closed, you stupid. You stupid. You crazy. You crazy for cuckoo. You cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, I don't even wear this kind of clothes. I usually wear my live, love, and laugh attire. But I felt I needed to put on the Playboy because I felt Playboy-ish for my boy LeBron because he's out here being a Playboy and, you know, making women sign NDAs and all that shit. I felt the need to put it on, put my Playboy chain on, got my shirt on. I'm gonna turn around for you. See, I got the girls on the end, got the back, the Playboy bunny in the back. There go the bunny teeth. Yeah, I felt the need to get real Playboy-ish for this video. Felt the need to get real Playboy-ish for this video. I don't know, Lakers fans. I don't know. This season is not looking good. Like I said, it just did not feel magical with LeBron and Anthony Davis and Russell Westbrook. It just don't feel magical. I don't feel nothing. You can accept him as a Laker. You can do whatever you want. I don't accept him as a Laker. And Kareem don't like it. I know Magic really don't like it. I mean, the rest of them might like it, you know, they might like it. They might like that LeBron James, but he ain't bringing it. He's not making the team better. You know, Magic made people better around Magic. Michael Jordan made people better around Michael. MJ made players around him better. Larry Bird made players around him better. LeBron has not really made players around him better. Not really. No, he hasn't. Not really. The ones that LeBron James has been around have already been good. You know what I'm saying? Like Kyrie Irving, he was already good. Kevin Love, he was already good. Dwayne Wade was already good. Chris Bosh was already good. Anthony Davis is already good. Russell Westbrook was already good, but now these guys, they act like they don't know how to play properly. Look, Anthony Davis, he's on sometime, all the time, or broken, or broke, whatever the fuck, injured on the sidelines. Russell Westbrook, he just forgot how to shoot, forgot how to play. No. No. Kobe, MJ, Larry, Magic, those guys, they would make you better. They would put their bring it out of you. They would make sure you was, and if you weren't better, they would take over. They would take over the game. Kobe was scoring like 60, 70 points a motherfucking game. Like, motherfucker, fuck it. You don't want to shoot? You want to play today? I will do it. Same thing with Michael. Same thing with Larry. When it came crunch time, and you needed a bucket, you needed 3 points, they would get it for you. And now it'd be game. Something about LeBron is just... It just don't feel the same. It don't. I don't feel any greatness from when it comes crunch time. You would think, you know, I'm gonna put in LeBron's games, LeBron's gonna make it happen. I don't feel that for LeBron. I don't feel if I put the ball in LeBron's hands in the last 3 seconds, it's gonna be magical. It sometimes is, but it's not enough of it. You know what I'm saying? It's just not enough magic for me. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Live Love Loud Show. Please do me a favor. Like, share, leave a comment. Please do that. No, I don't need no Cash App. I don't need none of that. I do this for fun. But please, like I said, like, share, subscribe. Subscribe to Your Entertainment. Subscribe. It goes down here. I'm telling you, it goes down. I do it all here. It goes down. Ladies and gentlemen, like I said, like, share, comment. You can hate it too. You can put a hate mark. I hate this show. It's stupid. It's dumb. Please leave a hate. Do that. Leave a hate. Do something. It's free to do something. It's free to like or dislike. It's free. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, live, love, and laugh. Live life to the fullest. Love yourself. And learn to laugh some goddamn time. Learn to laugh. Some of y'all motherfuckers are stuck up. God damn, shit.